Okay, all of you are welcome to the Monday meditation session of BSV. Normally we are doing this meditation session in BSV Hall. Now we are doing this YouTube broadcast from Newbury Buddhist Monastery. So the people who are listening through the YouTube can ask questions at the end of the meditation session through the live chat. So you are welcome to ask questions at the end of the session through the live chat. So today, normally we do give an introduction or motivate our minds to engage in meditation. We take about 15 minutes to give this introduction, and then I will do a guided meditation about 15 minutes. Then we will continue this meditation session up to 8:30 of the Australian Eastern Time. So at the end, you can ask questions through live chat. Okay. I am Bhante Aranavihari. So today I would like to remind you again, we are meditating to enjoy the peacefulness of our mind. That is the purpose. So not for doing things, not to achieve anything, but let go things and free all the attachments, burdens, leave all the burdens aside and calm down our mind. Rest, give a rest and peaceful time to our body and mind. So that is the purpose of meditation, relaxation. It makes your mind healthy and strong. So, you know, when you are doing work using your body, you are running up and down, you're doing this thing, that thing, then your body get tired. In the same way, when you are thinking all the time or doing planning, doing so many things by your mind, so the mind get tired. And my mind get weak. So that's why it is important to give a rest to your mind. So you have to reserve a time period for resting. So therefore, that's why that is the main purpose of meditation. Then your mind become healthy. In the same time, if you have some negative mental states, you can learn how to abandon negative mental states and make your mind happy. So this is also another benefit of practicing meditation. You give a good training to let go things and free your mind from thinking. Because thinking most of the time leads to unhappiness. Or sometimes thinking leads to more work, more doings, more planning, more expectations. In future, I will get this thing, that thing. I must achieve this level, that level. This kind of thinking always create the future plans and future intentions, then these things come to your mind, you are always active, bodily and mentally both. So you don't get a rest. So then sometimes these things leads to stress and some mental disorders also can arise in your mind. So that's why the disorders also you may experience in your life. So that's why it is good to train yourself to let go things. So therefore, it is important to, I would like to remind you here, as a Buddhist monk, so I think the understanding about this, the nature of our body and mind is really helpful to calm down our mind. Because Lord Buddha say this, any of the components of your body and mind can't take as yours. All these, the components related to body and mind are arising this moment based on causes and conditions to appear here or exist here based on different causes and conditions. When the causes and conditions change, your materiality and mentality, or your body and mind, change. So that is the nature. So your feelings, perceptions, and volitions change. That is your mind part. You can see it. You can understand it. In the same time, your body also change time to time, depending on changing causes and conditions. When a cold breeze is going, so then you feel cold. When the atmosphere become warm and hot, you feel hot. Like that, your body also experiencing the external world. In the same time, internally also happening many things. Sometimes if you eat some food and indigestion come your stomach, then the stomach suffering comes. These kind of things, many experiences, you know. The body and mind is impermanent, change. So based on different causes and conditions. So therefore, you know clearly, these are not really under your control. Body and mind change according when the causes and conditions are changing. So therefore, we know this is the nature of body and mind. That is the reality of this world. When we come to exist in this world, so it is inevitable. It is always happening. So therefore, we have to admit this reality and let the things be. Be kind to all the reality, because there is no way to solve all these things happening within ourselves. We can try to find out the solutions for some issues, but once you solve one issue, so the another issue arises. Then you have to run up and down to find out a solution for that new issue. So once you solve it, another arise. Not only one, sometimes too many problems arise at once sometimes. So always you are doing things. So you can't get a rest easily. So the important thing is solving problem is not the way you are making your mind calm and quiet. So when you want to make your mind and body calm and quiet, you should let go things. You should free your mind from all doings, all intentions, all wanting business. You just let go, free your mind. So that is the way how we practice meditation, letting go and free your mind. So the wanting is the enemy of letting go. So you have to understand all this wanting always based on delusion, not understanding there is no end of all these issues and thinking, and all the volitions arise in your mind, arise because causes and conditions. You are depending on these volitions. So because this mind always run based on delusion, you think this thinking leads to solving problems. Yes, maybe, but there is no end. You can solve one problem, then another two arise. Then you have to solve those problems. Another arise. So, if you see this nature of your life, so Lord Buddha says, this is the nature of the body and mind, because always this body and mind run based on delusion. So, therefore, you have to admit this nature and let go, let the things be. If it is necessary for your day-to-day life to do something, then you have to do. But in this meditation period, you can abandon all doings because you reserve this time period for practicing meditation. So you can postpone all thinking and just keep this time period for enjoying the silent stillness of the mind. So that is how we practice meditation. We give the courage to let go things. That means we value the silent stillness of the mind. And we are going to enjoy the peacefulness, calmness, and stillness of our body and mind. So then I would like to remind another point. We are not going to sleep. So sometimes we think we are practicing meditation is we are spending time in a half asleep. No, we are fully aware of our body and mind, how it works. But we don't try to control our body and mind. So let the things be. We just watch what arises in our body and mind. Just let the things be. Be kind. We cultivate the attitude, caring attitude towards our body and mind. Be kind, be soft, and be gentle. And be happy in the same time. Because the enemy of happiness is wanting. Want to do this thing, that thing. So I want like to be like this. I want to be like that. This mind should be like this. This mind should be like that. This kind of attitude always create discontentment. So discontentment lead to more doings and restlessness. So if you let the things be, then the mind naturally become calm and quiet and peaceful. So therefore, in this meditation session, we always kind to our body and mind. Whatever thing arises in our mind, we are going to be kind, soft, and gentle to our body and mind. Okay, now we can start the guided meditation session. Okay, so now you can sit comfortably. So if you are sitting on a chair, it is okay. Or if you can sit on a cushion on ground, so it is okay. Good. So if you lean against a wall or a backrest, it is also okay. So you have to try and see. Because some people say when they are resting against a backrest, sometimes they fall into sleep. So anyway, if you are mindful, you never fall into sleep. So these are habits of past habits. So it doesn't matter. If you have to arouse your mindfulness and watch what is going on in your mind and body. Don't try to control anything. Then you can sit in a comfortable posture. Okay, now you watch about your sitting posture. Now you have to focus your mind to your internal body and body. So you can focus your mind to your body. So focus your mind to head to toe and toe to head. Be aware what is going on, whether it is comfortable or not. Let your body and mind calm and quiet. Focus your attention to your legs and see whether the muscles of the leg legs are relaxed or stressed. So if there are any muscles having a stress, you can relax it and make it comfortable. Adjust and make it comfortable. Focus your attention to your buttocks, the back, so then you can see whether your cushion or sitting chair is comfortable. If there is anything uncomfortable, you can adjust and make more comfortable for sitting about 45 minutes. So therefore, it is important to let go your body. So therefore, make your body comfortable. Now focus your attention to the back side of your body and shoulders. So if you want, you can adjust whether it is leaning to the front or back. So you can adjust and make it more comfortable. Now you can move your attention to your hands, both hands. You can relax all the hand muscles and adjust your hands to forget for 45 minutes. Make your hands comfortable and nice. Now focus your attention to your neck and see whether neck is comfortable. And then focus your attention to your face and see whether the face muscles are relaxed and comfortable. You can make a slight smile in your face, a happy mood. Sometimes it is useful. Now you can focus your attention to your whole body and see whether there is no pain, whether it is comfortable. If you see any pain, you can adjust your seat or do whatever thing now, just now, because after this stage we let go of our body and focus our attention to our mind. So now you can see how your mind is behaving. If your body is comfortable, you are now happy because you see the comfortability of your body and stillness of your body. Enjoy the stillness of the body and focus your attention to your mind so they see the happiness in your mind. If the thoughts are coming into your mind, don't worry, but keep your attention on your mind. Sometimes your mind may distract and go with the thoughts. But don't worry, when you understand it, you should not worry about it. Just let the things be. Be kind to your mind. Then mind naturally become calm and quiet and come to your meditation practice or meditation objects. Always keep in mind, mind is a natural phenomena. It is rising and passing away, so we have to be kind, soft and gentle to it. That wholesome mentality makes your mind calm and quiet and letting go all the unwholesome mental states. And that is the way how we practice meditation. past has gone, finish. We can't do anything. Whatever thing happened in the past. Future is uncertain. Future, we don't know what will happen in future. So therefore, thinking about past and future is just wasting time. So cut off the value of thinking about past or future. Let go all the past and future and enjoy the silent stillness of the mind now. Enjoy the present moment, silent stillness of the mind. If any thinking arises, just let it be, let it go. Don't worry about it. Be kind, soft and gentle to your mind and body. If there any inner commentary is going on, just let it be silent. Enjoy the silent stillness of the mind. Let go all inner talk. if any visual objects are coming into mind, into your mind, then just let go and focus into the brighter point of the mind and keep your attention on the bright part of the mind. And let go all the forms related to the five sense world. When your mind becomes silent and quiet, you can clearly see the breath. If you are seeing the breath, you can keep your attention on the breath and mindfully watch which direction is breath is going, whether it is going in or whether it is going out. You can keep your attention on your breath. If still thoughts are coming into your mind, be kind, soft and gentle. Just focus to your breath or let the things be. Be kind, soft and gentle to your mind. And try to enjoy the silent stillness of the mind. enjoy silent stillness of the body and mind. Now we are getting close to the end of meditation session. How blissful your body and mind, how calm and peaceful your body and mind. What you have done to feel in this way? I will ring the gong 3 times, then you can open your eyes. Okay, now if you have any questions, you can post in live chat, then I can answer. So when we are practicing meditation, it is important to keep in mind whatever thing, whatever disturbance come to our practice or meditation, we don't worry. We just let the things be. We let the things go. We are always kind, soft and gentle to our body and mind. Why? Because body and mind is a natural phenomena. It is happening based on causes and conditions. That is the understanding we get by listening to Buddha Dhamma Sangha. Is there any questions are coming in? No. Okay. So 1 more minute or 2 minutes we can wait and see. If there's no questions, we can end our meditation program. Okay, now we are going to end our meditation program. So we are going to pay respect to Buddha, Dhamma and Sangha.
Arahaṃ sammā sambuddho bhagavā buddhaṃ bhagavantaṃ abhivāde. Svākhāto bhagavatā dhammo dhammaṃ namassāṃ. Supatipanno bhagavato savaka sangho sanghaṃ